I really just watched as many westerns as I possibly could. I watched a lot of John Wayne westerns, but my favorite ones, personal favorite ones, are the ones from the 70s. The sort of things like Little Big Man and the sort of the so-called dirty westerns, where there's sort of a little more reality. Oh, the Butch and Sundance is obviously a big favorite of mine. I kind of John and I had these chats. I think, and it helped me a great deal because obviously I had to be an American in the film. Is the less I said, the better, and that I'd sort of use sort of just sort of I try and sort of let everybody else do the talking and I do the action. So really, that's where I base my character, sort of very much on the silent sort of Clint Eastwood, sort of like you said, the man with no name. It was so important for all of us and all of the filmmakers and all the people involved with making of this film that we wanted to make first and foremost a good Western. And we wanted the audience to be sucked into this, the idea that they were watching a good Western. Otherwise, it would have felt like we were in a sort of non-existent world. So the film, I think, is set in 1873, and it had to feel like it was 1873. Well, he's a kind of hero of mine. I mean, John said that he, it's in an interview that it's, he's kind of our generation's John Wayne. I mean, it's kind of, for me, it's even more than that, really. I mean, if you think sort of about Star Wars, but then things like Blade Runner and movies that sort of were seminal, really, when in my kind of movie life, or sort of growing up with movies. So I was nervous as hell when I sort of started working with him, but. He's nearly nice, so it's okay. There's a mining town that's down on its luck, and Dolarhyde's ruling it with an iron fist, and is sort of a dictator of this small town, and is tougher probably than he should be, but he's got a heart of gold, and sort of, I think Jake sort of pushes them a little towards, in spite of, they're both tough guys and they both come up against each other and clash, but through this sort of common purpose, they find the sort of softer side in each other and are kind of a firm friends by the end of the movie. We're all stuck out in the middle of a beautiful place, Santa Fe, on location in this amazing place, and the light was amazing. And as a unit and as a crew and the actors would get together, and I haven't done that for a long time, and I'd kind of hold parties at my house just to sort of kind of get people to bond. Some of the crew would come along, I'd get the actors to come along, Olivia would come along, and Olivia was sort of major instigator of that. Basically, she'd sort of push me to have another party, so we'd have margarita nights on a sort of Friday or Saturday night after work, and get Harrison would come over, and Sam, we'd get the music going, and so we kind of really, we just, we all really got on. I mean, I'm not just saying that for this interview. We really did. You'll be pulled in by these characters who are all proper and real. And Sam Rockwell, who's obviously just funny without even trying. And Harrison, who's playing a bad guy, I think probably for the first time, really. And playing a cowboy, he's done it before, but he hasn't done it for a long time. He was kind of a cowboy in Star Wars, and Olivia, who's just sort of beautiful and great, and me, I'm wearing chaps, and some people would pay money for that.